We are back. This is our second part of 25th December, and our topic is assault in the arm on new modes of COVID-19 treatment. First of all, I would like to wish you a Merry Christmas Day. And so let's start our topic. New modes of treatment offer greater hope in dealing with COVID-19. A full vaccination using any COVID-19 vaccine greatly reduces a person's risk of progressing to severe disease and death than the move by the US FDA to grant emergency use authorization, EUA, emergency use authorization to oral antiviral drugs for certain categories of people who are likely to become severely ill, provides a much needed flip to fight the disease, unlike in the case of remdesivir. These drugs, Pfizer, Paxlovid, and Molnupiravir, are oral pills and so can be administered outside hospital settings. They are meant for use by people with mild, moderate disease within 5 days of symptom onset. Paxlovid, an antiviral drug, was the first to be granted an EUA on December 22 and has been green-lighted for above 12 years use. Molnupiravir, with an EUA on December 23 for only above 18 years use. Paxlovid has 88% efficacy in preventing COVID-19 related hospitalization or death, while molnupiravir has only 30% efficacy in achieving the same endpoint. The efficacy of the molnupiravir dropped from 50% during interim analysis to 30% in the final analysis of the trial data. The FDA specifically mentions that molnupiravir is recommended when alternative treatment options are not accessible or clinically appropriate. Both pills are likely to work against Omicron, with the biggest gainers being immunocompromised people who may lack sufficient immunoprotection despite being fully vaccinated. Antivirals can never substitute vaccines, and hence every eligible individual should get fully vaccinated as soon as possible, especially as the highly transmissive Omicron variant is spreading, since treatment should begin within 5 days of symptoms onset. Access to testing and turnaround times should vastly improved. At the same time, indiscriminate use of the drugs should be avoided. This will not only cause complications of individual patients but also lead to drug resistance, unlike in the use of COVID-19 vaccines, where access and availability have become a sore point for many low and middle income countries. But drugs will be far more freely accessible there. This is because of the agreement that the companies have reached the medicine patent pool. As in the agreement, generic manufacturers are permitted to produce and supply Paxlovid to 95 low and middle income countries, while 105 countries will have access to the generic version of molnupiravir. India should be able to manufacture the generic versions of both drugs and supply them to the approved countries, as well as access them here at a lower price. With increased coverage of vaccination and easier availability of treatment, the world will be better placed to deal with the fast mutating virus. Thank you. We will meet on 26th December. Thank you. Have a nice day. Please like this video and share this channel as much as possible. Thank you.